Gracias. 3, Proverbs 18. The Bible says, and he said, thy deceit be, show me thy glory. And he said, I will make all thy goodness pass before thee. And I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee. And I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious. And I will show mercy on whom I will show mercy. And he said, thou canst not see like my face, for there is no man see me and live. And the Lord said, behold, there is a place by me. Thou shalt stand upon a rock, and it shall come to pass, while my glory passeth by, but that I will put thee in a cleft of the rock, and I will cover thee with my hand, while I pass by, and I will take away my hand, and thou shalt see my purpose, but my face shall not be seen. Here we see Moses, and that's the Lord to show himself to him. And this morning, even as we call upon God, even as we ask the Lord to show himself strong in our lives, the Lord will hearken and do every prayer that we raise today. And as we ask him to show us his glory, the Lord is here to answer every prayer and every petition, to answer everything that we ask him. And so let us draw near and near to the Lord this morning. And even as Moses asked, the Lord answered him and he showed himself. And he directed him on what he was going to do, even on that instruction of him coming. And so we are asking the Lord to show us his glory today. We are asking him to come and fight our battles today.
Thank you.
now, O Father, glorify thou me with thy whole self, the glory which I had in thee before the world was. I have manifested thy name unto men, which thou gavest out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept the word. Now they have known that all things whatsoever thou hast given me are of thee. For I have given unto thee the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came out from thee, and they have believed that thou didst send me. I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are mine, and all mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to thee, Holy Father, through thine own name, those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept in thy name, but those that thou gavest me I have kept, and none of them is lost, but the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. And now I come to thee, and these things I speak to the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in themselves. I have given them thy word, and thy word hated them, because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. I pray not that thou shouldest take them out of the world, but that thou shouldest keep them from the evil. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. And that as thou hast sent me into the world, even so I have also sent them into the world. And for their sake, I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through the truth. Neither pray I thee for this alone, but for them also which shall believe on me through their word. That they all may be one, as thou, Father, art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that thou hast sent me. The glory which thou gavest me, I have given to them, that they may be one, even as we are one. I in them, and thou in me, that they may be made perfect in one, and that the world may know that thou hast sent me, and hast loved them, and thou hast loved me. Father, I will that they also, whom thou hast given me, be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory, which thou hast given me. For thou lovest me before the foundation of the world. O righteous Father, the world hath not known thee, but I have known thee, and these have known thou hast sent me. And I have declared unto them thy name, and I will declare thee, that the love wherewith that thou hast loved me may be in them, and I in them. And you see Jesus praying in the disciples. What the scripture says, the Father and the Son are one. And yet Jesus was looking all the glory that he shared with the Father. And he was asking the Father that he may release this glory upon his disciples and upon everyone who hears his word. And we have seen here that the Bible says we are not of the world. And because we are not of the world, then for so long as the glory of the Lord is upon us, then the evils of this world shall not. And so the same prayer that the Lord prayed, we are bringing it to the Lord today. And we are asking that the Lord will release His glory upon us. And as He releases His glory upon us, we become one with the Lord. And because we are one with the Lord, and His glory is upon us, then nothing in this world should terrify us. Nothing in this world should defeat us, because His glory and His victory is upon us. And where the glory of the Lord is, then there is a sure victory. And as we come before the Lord today, we are asking the Lord that we may come closer and closer to Him, that we may come closer to Him, and we may receive His glory, that this glory may cause us to be one with the Lord, to be one with the Lord, and as we come one with the Lord, then we are not of the world, and because we are not of the world, we therefore then partake everything that the Lord has done for us in this season. In this season where we are in the new horizon, the transformation. In this season of our inheritance, we need the glory of the Lord, because it is only the glory of the Lord that is able to keep us in our inheritance. Because as long as we want with God, then the enemy is not able to steal that which God has prepared for the day for us.
Oh, Thank you.
Colossians chapter 2, from verse 13 to 15. From verse 13 to 15. Here we see the victory of the cross and the victory that Jesus gave us when he was hung on the cross. And here we see, as Gentiles, those who are Gentiles at that time, we became partakers of this. to the impossible this morning. Even as you have come to comfort us, even as you have come to triumph for us, we pray, Lord, that you may do that which no man can do. May you do, Lord, much more than we have ever thought or even imagined. We pray, Lord, that your plans and your purposes for this ministry, for this work, for each and every one of us, may come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As we call upon you, Lord, we pray that, Lord, you will come into a mighty